the people around the game and the game. It was a great ride. I'd never pass it up for anything. And I just adored the game of basketball. All my dreams and all my plans, this is where they all
begin. Okay, so this is my father, Dennis Miller, and that's my grandfather, Les Miller. We try to shoot bow, try to once a week throughout the summer if we can. Oh, that's good.
I'm a little better than he is at bow.
I'll give it to him.
But I shoot way more than he does. Yeah. I will say that. He's got a job to go to there in the city. He's always been a fiery kid. He wanted to win hockey or baseball or whatever he was playing, even archery. It's just he always wants to win.
Boom. I'm pretty sure that's where you want to be.
That's pretty good.
Oh! Uh-oh. Oh, my God.
I broke the target, guys. Oh, boy.
That's worst case scenario. The deer suffers its whole life. These two are great, and this is mine, the best one. I kind of went hunting more with him than you when I was younger.
Yeah.
So he actually taught me pretty much what I know in the woods, especially to fall asleep. You know, he's pretty.
Yeah. Wake him up when the deer shows up.
Maybe the best at it I've seen in the woods.
Yeah.
Just a peaceful place. I'm JT Miller. And this is my beginnings.
This episode of Beginnings is presented by Audi.
What's up, guys? We're in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania right now, just outside the city, going into Humburger Performance, where I work out around 9 a.m. every day. So just trying to go get the lift in to start the day, and I hope it's a good one.
How many?
80.
Huh?
80 quick.
I've been working with JT since he was 15 or 16. I helped get him ready for the U.S. program, and he just kept getting better and improving and developing. Hold that bar with your left hand. Squat down, too. Good. In the summers, we go 5 days a week. A lot of work to be put in to prepare for next season. We keep it intense and we keep it fun. You can hear him giving me a hard time and just jabbing with the guys.
You ever seen Waterboy when the mom's in the background like this?
He and I are always arguing about training times because, hey, I want to see my grandma. Hey, I'm going to golf with my dad. It's always spending it with family. He has a very, very tight circle.
You know, that's how we are. We're a family type people from small town Ohio area. And, you know, it's family's what you got. And stick together and stick to people you know and trust.
Abs tight. Use your back. That's right, Dad.
Don't miss. Don't let me miss in front of everybody. Respect that.
It's family. And that's who JT is.
My little brother, Matt, is 2 years younger than me, and we were best friends and always have been, and we've always done everything together. I mean, took him under my wing a little bit and was living with me this summer and tried to just show him stuff that I know I didn't know when I was that age. You know, I just want to help him. It's not good when he keeps up with Big Bro. One, two more. Come on. You use your heels. One more. I know. Gotcha. Go. It's all you. It's all you. It's all you. Good job. But, you know, back in the back of my mind, I don't want him to get it just because it's the same weight as what I was doing. But good to see little bros catching up, getting stronger. He's gonna be 20 soon, and you know, it's good for me and him to have a little competition. It's just a little extra push. Anything sports and athletic wise, it's always competition. I remember one-on-one wiffle ball, pitcher hitter. That's it. You know, you got tremendous respect for each other. You know, there's times where you want to, you know, strangle each other, but that's how it works.
We've gotten into it quite a few times, obviously. I mean, big brother, little brother.
We like
we'll fight once a day and then make up.
We're down to butt heads. We're a lot alike and a lot different in a lot of ways. So things have progressed as a friendship for us over the years. We're coming from the suburbs of Pittsburgh right now, and heading just straight towards the Ohio border. I played hockey 10 minutes from here, really close, you know, starting at the age of 12. So like for 5-6 years, we were taking this road 3 days a week and then on the weekends, me and my brother. So my dad was going maybe 4 days a week driving us, but my mom was working. So it's 50 minutes, 45 minutes all the way to the rink from home. Taking this road a lot of times.
Well, it's kind of unbelievable. I still have this car, actually. I wish I had it here right now. I got this old Grand Prix. I got 343,000 miles on it, and that's mostly all hockey miles.
A lot of good car rides, playing the hockey game in the car, the name game. A lot of talks where we were in trouble, mainly why our schoolwork wasn't done before practice type things.
As far as the traveling, I loved it, because, you know, when they're at school or with their friends, you don't really get to spend much time with them, so it ended up being great quality time going on them trips.
Mom was working like crazy, traveling all over the country to work. Dad worked, you know, 7-to-4 job, and then he'd come home, make a sandwich, up in the car. We're gone until 9 or 10 at night.
His little brother was 2 years younger, so sometimes his practices would be at like 5:30, and his wouldn't start till 9 o'clock at night. So not only that, but we would be there the entire evening, get home at 1 o'clock at night. It was long days for sure.
The amazing thing is they put that much time into just getting me to practice, just to play on the best team in your local area, just to do that for our future, shows you how important it was for them to just make sure we got there. It takes you a long time to appreciate that. You don't appreciate it when you're younger, but you do now. Getting off here, should be there in 10 minutes. Anytime you get here, you're pretty close to home. So we're in my hometown, East Palestine, Ohio. We're on North Avenue. This is 123 here. This is where my grandmother lived for several years of my childhood. Two houses down from my house. She raised me a lot of the time. My dad was out working during the summer, and you know, she definitely played a big part of, you know, taking care of us as a kid when my mom was out working and dad was out working. And literally not even 100 feet down, you have 143 West North Avenue, which is where I grew up, in this house here. Obviously, this is where I lived from kindergarten up till 10th grade, and you know, it's pretty unique to have grandma there, mom, dad here. This is where I have all my memories, playing sports with my brother and friends, and you know, most of the time we spent was out back. Follow me. This yard was where we did a lot of our, you know, practice your pitching before your baseball games. The main thing, though, was definitely the ice rink my dad built me as a kid. I think it was like 30 feet by 18 feet wide. Went and got the big plastic from Home Depot, built the boards. I mean, it took up probably, you know, 75-80% of the yard. So in the winter months, the whole yard was useless, but we did that just for the better of me and my brother using it, and our buddies too that could skate. I remember as a kid, I would go out and skate at 6 a.m. every morning before school, and it was cold and it was miserable, but you know, at the time, you're just doing what you love and doing, trying to get better at the game at even, you know, 12, 13 years old. The garage over here still is missing the windows because they were replaced so many times that you just stopped putting them in from missing. And the neighbors as well boarded up there. I don't know how a puck got over there, but, you know, on here, you can still see actually golf balls, pucks, everything, and it's a loud building. So every time you hit it, the whole town, you seem like they know what you were doing. And that's where it starts, is in this backyard, and you know, it brings back a lot of good memories. I'm the first person, I think, from my hometown to like ever play, really.
It was on the ice 3 weeks before his second birthday. It was a disease at that point.
Hey guys, we're at my apartment here in Coriopolis, PA, right outside of Pittsburgh. My girlfriend Natalie, my mom Jen, and two dogs are in there, so we're gonna go see what they're up to.
There's JT. He is now 15 days old.
Remember this picture with the really bad hair?
That's one of my better hairdos. That might be the worst. It's like Lloyd Christmas from
How big
and
is
Dumber.
He? This big. Best part of when you and your brother wore the same stuff.
Grandma thought we were actually twins. Corduroy pants.
You can see him with his baby brother. I mean, he was absolutely loved that kid and started beating him up at a very young age. I do have some pictures of that, you holding him upside down. But yeah, he was a big Matt Miller fan. He absolutely loved his brother. Overall, he's a pretty good kid, but...
Can we tell the yo-yo story?
Go ahead.
Me and Matt were fighting. It was his yo-yo, so I got mad at him, flushed it down the toilet. Like 2 hours later, the ceiling in the kitchen's dripping.
Niagara Falls.
Her and my dad's not home, and the babysitter's there. Like, within 20 minutes, I look in, the whole kitchen caved in. It literally flooded. Like, we were like, I'm just sitting there, like, I want to be dead. Like, there's nothing. Like, I don't even want to be here when they come home. Babysitter quit that afternoon. It was just an absolute disaster over a yo-yo.
And that's when I thought you were going to be a superstar because I put you in a magazine.
Not a real magazine, Mom.
And this is where you'll never forgive me because
world
of
record
this.
Setting neck guard length.
Is that the time where I pinned your shoulder pads and the safety pin came undone and stabbed
yes,
you in the back?
That team. Yes, that and we taped my shin guards to my bare skin.
Well, I'm waiting for the Mother of the Year medal. It'll where
be
is
the
it?
Hockey team.
Yes. Okay.
It's pretty crazy in general how I started playing hockey. I'm the first person, I think, from my hometown to like ever play. My dad was, I mean, both of them were big into sports, but my dad was like baseball, football, and the Penguins won the cup in like 90. I was born
91.
Yeah, 91, and I was born 93. So he was like, oh, this is pretty cool, the home team winning. So I watched again, and then they happened to win the back-to-back year. So at that point, my dad was automatic, was like, you're playing hockey.
He was on the ice 3 weeks before his second birthday. It was a disease at that point.
Where's that Frisbee? We gotta get one. Hey, where's Frisbee?
I don't know.
Easton, come here. Come on, ready? You're so bad at no pressure. Hey,
can't wait to catch that.
There we go. Ah. Okay, so we're in the backyard of our apartment. It's good enough for the two dogs, Easton and Lincoln. We got a year old, they got him last year in the playoffs, and they got him in the playoffs this year. This is Natalie, my girlfriend. We've been together for almost 7 years coming up, which is a long time for us being young. What can I say? I must have woed her with all of the, obviously, my good looks and personality after that.
He's a charmer.
She's lying right through your teeth.
He's just very different looking now than he was when he was 15. You know, when you're in your height of your puberty, like long hair. Like, we might have had the same hair length at one point. I had real short hair. You never cut yours.
Tell me how was that.
He was a little more plump than he is now. The first day I met him, he had a thing of Oreos on his lap. And I was like talking to my friends, like, this kid. And he's chirping me, and I'm just like, what? It wasn't meant to be at all. My friends all thought he was cute, and I was like, he needs to slim down on those Oreos. I see what he was when he was 15 years old and immature, and it's nice to watch him grow into a man. And the one thing I've always said to like my friends and family is that he's never changed. He's still that country boy in the city. And I mean, that's what I love about him. So I love that he hasn't changed, and I think that's made it easiest for this whole transition into him becoming a professional.
Welcome to the 2011 National Hockey League Entry Draft.
All of a sudden, it happened.
You're going to be proudly selected from the U.S. development team, JT Miller.
Welcome to the 2011 National Hockey League Entry Draft.
Draft night was stressful. I just, for some reason, I know it didn't matter when I got picked. It was just going to be an awesome thing regardless. But if you're on the border going first round, I mean, it's a big deal.
I was born in Brooklyn, New York. And right before they started announcing the New York stuff, I'm like, yo, JT, I'm from Brooklyn. This might happen. Just totally kidding. And all of a sudden, it happened.
New York Rangers will proudly select from the U.S. development team, JT Miller.
We're not even looking to reach out to him. We're celebrating. And he's looking at us like, what just happened?
JT Miller goes 15th overall to the New York Rangers.
It was finally 15 years of hard work, and your son just reached a major milestone in his life. At that point, I'm like, oh, he might get paid to play with a puck and a stick. That's kind of cool.
I think we have 100 pictures here.
At least.
It's kind of like a time-lapse thing.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, I got emotional when I got upstairs and seen everybody. Yeah. That was what got me.
Your grandparents, you don't see them emotional and cry like that every day. That was tough.
I actually didn't cry until his grandfather walked up to me and he was like, JT couldn't have done this without you. And I mean, that means a lot to me. So obviously I got emotional over it. It's a huge milestone in his life and I was happy to be there for it.
On his NHL debut, all eyes will be on Miller tonight.
I just got called up the day before.
He's a 19-year-old center who was the team's number one draft pick.
I was actually on the second power play in the first game, and my job was to come off the bench, swing in the corner, get speed up the left wing, and they cross-corner dumped one into my side, and I was going as fast as I possibly could. You're amped up, like it's my first NHL shift. I went to go up on one leg and hit it at full speed, and I toe-picked and went to the boards at full speed. I think the whole rink thought I was dead. Like, it got quiet, and I got up, I was like seeing stars, and I just was like, should I go to the bench? I'm like, I don't know, I want to act like I'm not hurt. I couldn't breathe. Like, it was quite the way to jump into it. My dad and my brother were laughing so hard after the game, telling me how funny they thought it was. They're like, I mean, it was like 10 seconds of NHL playing time and didn't exactly go how I wanted to. Man, I kind of got it like the spoiled way to start. Like, I played a good game that game, almost had a couple of assists. I didn't have any points.
Stroman to JT Miller, S in front.
And obviously the second game scoring, my first shift of the game.
It's a chance for JT Miller. He scores! His first NHL goal!
Being a big factor against the Islanders and scoring again the second.
Here goes JT Miller to the net. Sonny, he scores! JT Miller!
I thought it was always going to go like that. And, you know, I already went 30 games, 35 games without scoring after that. That was the lockout year. I played half the year, got sent down, realized that how hard it is to stay and how hard it is to succeed in that league. That's pretty much your welcome to the NHL moment. I mean, it's a welcoming there. It's a humbling experience.
Feels like your time off goes quick, but at the same time, you're back and ready to start training again. We have a small group that we've skated with for a couple years now, so I'm excited. Working the skills a little bit. Just gotta get the feel for it.
Hey, down here!
When I go skating, we got our group together. On Tuesday, Thursdays, I'm here with Grant Springer. I've known him my whole life.
Backhand to forehand, all right? Out here, and then shot.
All right. We met back in Youngstown. I was just learning to skate. I was like, what, five years old, something like that. And I don't know, we just kind of kept in touch a little bit. And then over the last probably 4 or 5 years, we've been training together every summer just for to get a little push, a little consistency, and a little conditioning.
There you go. I seen that kid playing out there, 5 years old, skating with 8, 9-year-olds. And I said, this kid's got some talent.
He's flashy, sharp on skates, and has dreams of the NHL.
I'm good at scoring goals and assists. I'm good at passing.
This 6-year-old from East Palestine scored 52 goals and assisted on 14 others.
He's the same kid that he was when he was 5 years old. Same tenacity that he has, the same feistiness he has on the ice as well. He always had a great work ethic, right? And you can't teach that. He had a great knowledge for the game. It was just so amazing to say that, hey, this kid's gonna be a first-round player.
Things got more serious for me, so it got more serious out here. Like before, we would just kind of show up and bring some pucks and shoot and mess around, and now we come out here to work whenever it's time to work. Let's do the download drills.
All right, go ahead, set it up.
And last summer, we put a good summer in. It was probably the best I went into camp, so.
Yes.
I've known him my whole life.
Open up, come. Yes.
So I know he's out here to push us, and he's the right guy to get done what we need to get done.
His great-grandma, she's 93 years old. She never misses a game. She's fallen asleep a few times during the game, but she watches every game.
I can never see that getting old, sitting there watching your kid. I love it. I really do. I love it.
We're at my favorite restaurant at Permane's here. I've been coming here for probably the last 10 years getting sandwiches. We're with Chris Stern. He's my coach my under 18 year when I played AAA. We had a great group of guys my year. And I was 15, 16 throughout the year. And they were 17, 18, so they were a little older. We were getting losing to this team like 15-0, and I scored one of the better goals I've actually literally ever scored of my life. And I'm like, no, I'm not really excited. We just we're losing. I skate back to the bench, and you always go through the line. And I get to the line, and the whole bench went like this, like, come on, give me it. And then everybody sat down at one by one, and I just missed everybody. It was like an instant classic.
The first thing that everyone says about you is, when you play the game, people can't tell the score. And that's, to me, as a coach, as a fan, as a parent, that's the highest compliment you could pay a player.
Here's Cowan. That's blocked. Nice play by JT Miller to get in front of the Jerry Cowan shot.
The thing that strikes me most in watching you play in the playoffs, the pass you made against Tampa Bay, freezing the goalie. I've seen you make that pass, practice that pass. You've probably done that 10,000 times. It was great to see your hard work paying off.
We stopped at a quick stop to get, like, of course, seeds and a Gatorade. And he came out all confident, sat down. He goes, you know, Mom, I'm going to take good care of you. I'm like, well, that's nice. He goes, no, seriously, I'm going to go to the NHL. And then you and Dad will never, ever have to worry about anything. And I looked at him like, well, that's thoughtful. He goes, yeah, I'm going to take care of you because I'm going to give you season tickets. I'm like, you're giving me half your signing bonus. You're not giving me season tickets. But yeah, he knew at six.
At that age, you're thinking, of course, I'm going to make the NHL. Of course, like, what else are you going to do? And then you grow up a little bit and you realize how tough it is. And then it's just a pretty surreal thing to look up in the stands and see what I see nowadays.
Good job, Sedley. Pass in front. Score! What a setup for JT Miller!
My country bumpkin, hunter, fisherman, go, you know, type of kid is going to live in Manhattan. Oh, no, you know? And to my surprise, he knows every subway. He does. I couldn't believe it. I could not believe how fast him and Natalie picked up on how to get it done in New York City.
And his A is beating it on a cross. Score!
Every now and again, I remember he's in the NHL. I'll look around and go, wow, he's here. But most of the time, I'm just going to another game.
These last couple of days of sitting here and going back through to see what can be done if everybody works together and we stick together. And it's humbling to look back and see, you know, how we keep getting stronger as a family, even though we're separated for 9 months out of the year.
His great-grandma, she's 93 years old. She never misses a game. She's fallen asleep a few times during the game, but she watches every game on TV.
I can never see that getting old, sitting there watching your kid. I love it. I do. I love it.
I really appreciate where I came from. I don't think I'd be where I am if it wasn't for that. You know, you tend to get a little spoiled sometimes, and I think a big part is just staying true to who you are and your family and, you know, Nat. And it's been a long couple of years, that's for sure. But, you know, it's finally to see some positive things come out of it. And, you know, this is just part of it.